So I'm James Knox. I'm here representing Santiam Organics, North America's longest standing mycorrhizal manufacturer. We provide a high performance endomycorrhizal product only for this industry. Really pushes the annual plants to their full potential. So mycorrhizal inoculants are a beneficial root fungus, and they're made to be applied to the root tissue. And what they do is they interface with the root tissue or grow into it, and then grow throughout it, and then grow back out of it, and help sequester more water and more phosphorus. So the primary function of mycorrhizae is to bring in more water to the plant tissue throughout the entire growth cycle, and more phosphorus during the bloom and fruiting cycle. Phosphorus is also attributed to root development. So obviously, the translation of having mycorrhizae on the root tissues in any crop production system is beneficial. The product itself is all organic, it's all natural, it's naturally occurring out in the forest. We just present it to you in a concentrated form that allows you to really pull that potential out of your plant. Dusted to the roots is how this product should be used. Any mycorrhizal product that is a pure inoculum is typically dusted right to the root tissue. It doesn't go in the planting hole. It's not supposed to be mixed into the soil per se. It goes right on the roots. So that's something that we really stress here at Santiam Organics and with the Myco-Fusion line, is making sure that you use the product properly and put it directly on the root tissue at transplant day. So when we're talking about the Green 150 and why we take this product and literally dust it to the roots, and so you'll literally take your white root tissue, take this material, spoon it on, salt shaker it on, just simply dump it on and cover that white root tissue. It'll be a darker, blacker color after you've dusted those roots, and what you've ensured is true surface area contact to the root tissue. That's the way mycorrhizae works. That's how it's intended to work. It does not work just sitting somewhere in the soil until that root finds it and comes into contact with it. So it being a pure inoculum, no fertilizers, no fillers, no weirdness, you're able to take this product, literally cover the root system on transplant day. And so say you're already transplanted and you don't intend to up-pot, we do provide another product that is a suspendable or soluble water-in mycorrhizal product. But truthfully at Santiam Organics, we really try to practice and preach dusting of the roots, because that's the most effective way to get good colonization and to get real quality effectiveness from a mycorrhizal product. Watering in does work, but not to the degree of dusting the roots. So this is the Green 150. It's a granular. You're gonna have a lot of material in here of different sizes. Got a little breather valve on the bag because these are live organisms, so everything in here is respirating a little bit. It's a nice, fine, granular powder. This is the product, you literally dust this onto the root tissue. So your white roots end up turning out that color. You can dust your rock wool cubes, your bark plugs, your bare root clones, and anytime you transplant, it's a good idea to re-dust the roots. The rhizocharge is step two in the process. We're Green 150, dusting the roots is step one. This is the dressing for the planting hole. You've got organisms in here that help benefit the plant, get it through transplant shock. You have humic material in here and other food sources to help feed the plant and feed the microorganisms. It's a dressing for the transplant hole, something you put in, whisk in, and then nestle your root ball over on top. And this is also a more thick, more moist type of granulate and micronized product. This is definitely alive to a degree that is much higher than most material. The moisture in here is typically a dry down from the manufacturing. You get a little bit of respiration and the organisms in here are ripping. Our third step of the process, or our third product, is gonna be our BioJolt. This is something that you drench in. Now the BioJolt's gonna be our finest micronized powder, and it really is a powder. And it is very hygrophobic at times. So once again, putting this into a smaller vessel with some water and shaking the heck out of it into a slurry, forcibly into a slurry, then you can take that and put it into your overall res. Some of our growers have noticed that it's a little hygrophobic and it can kind of be a pain to mix up, but it's well worth the trouble. This right here is a plant food. It's gonna be a microbial food source. It's a really good substitute for compost tea. It's very easy to use. People that are brewing tea with our BioJolt exclusively, I have recommended growers early season. Early season being outdoor, greenhouse, or maybe vegetative, to do a half and half volume. So do half rhizocharge and half biojolt in the tea. Ironically, with the blue label, we call it plant Viagra because typically the plants stand up, they're very much at attention. The plant response is usually noticeable within 24 hours. A really good additive to any program. It's compatible with any fertilizer program, any growing system, in a soilless soil media. It really is a one of a kind. I mean, grower to grower, I can't emphasize it enough. This will help increase plant health, vitality, bouquets, aroma, overall biomass. It's a really one-off product. This is Dr. Linderman's little secret sauce. It's an amazing product. Should be and can be used as much as every 7 days. Some growers will take it out to every 14 days.